2020 was really challenging for us. We were dealing with a lot of protocol changes to keep our responders as safe as possible from COVID while responding to these animals. But this large mass stranding of dolphins in August will stick out in, I think, a lot of people's memories. We received a report early in the morning of several live stranded dolphins in the Herring River gut. So we quickly dispatched volunteers to the scene, and they confirmed that there were 45 stranded common dolphins in that area. This stranding was definitely our largest of 2020, and it's definitely one of our largest mass strandings of all time. Our volunteers were able to help provide initial supportive care until we were able to get staff and other personnel on scene. We were able to extract 11 of those dolphins and move them to one of our rescue vehicles, where the animals received health assessments, 9 of which were relocated at a nearby release site, and then wheeled down to the beach and released. The remaining 32 animals that were at that stranding site refloated with the incoming tide. And then once they were free swimming, we were able to use vessels to gently herd those animals out of the Wellfleet Harbor area, where the water is deeper and where they're hopefully less likely to strand. So this was a pretty challenging response, definitely one of the most exhausting and difficult that I've been part of. But it was really inspiring to see everyone come together to help out and work really hard and do the best that we could for these animals. With strandings like this, we are, you know, always looking for more ways to improve and to care for more animals and help alleviate some of the challenges that we faced. And actually, just a few weeks after this stranding, we actually received a custom rescue vehicle.
I'm here with the brand new Mobile Dolphin Rescue Clinic. This one-of-a-kind vehicle that's going to provide a safer way for us to rescue dolphins and also safer for our responders.
So it really serves the purpose of an ambulance for these animals. It is quite a bit larger than our previous trailer, so it allows for us to care for more animals at one time, which is a huge improvement.
We'll be able to hold up to 6 animals back here. And then this is our lab, so this is where we'll hold all of our diagnostic equipment, and we'll be drawing up medications for our animals.
It also has more storage.
Stretchers, dry suits, mud mats.
And allows us to keep all of the gear we need for response in it at all times. So now we can get on the road much quicker and get to these animals faster. And since it has arrived, we have taken it out in the field with us several times to respond to live dolphins. And we're really looking forward to continuing to rescue and give these animals the best care possible. You know, there's nothing like, after a long day, releasing a group of dolphins with the sunset, seeing them take off and swim well, and knowing that you've hopefully given those animals a second chance to thrive out in the wild.